From Delhi, Supreme Court advocate Ranjit Kumar takes a pro Gujarat government's position. TSR Subramaniam, former cabinet secretary Nirmala Sitharaman, national spokesperson of the BJP, Shakti Singh Gohil, Congress leader of the opposition in Gujarat. With me in the studio, D.R. Karthikeyan, former director of the Central Bureau of Investigation. We'll have K.C. Mittal, who's former president of the Delhi High Court Bar Association and a pro-Congress voice, joining us in just a couple of minutes. Mr. Shakti Singh Gohil, the BJP had a press conference today, and the charge was very specific, that the CBI is being totally misused to now fix a BJP leader, Gulab Chand Kataria, in a fake encounter case. You may have heard the press conference. Does it seem strange to you, Mr. Shakti Singh Gohil, that on the one hand, Pawan Kumar Bansal is being let off by the CBI 5 days after Railgate, and a BJP leader is being pulled in?
Arnav, we'll have to understand one thing, that the entire investigation in this fake encounter case is not by CBI its own. Supreme Court has directed CBI to investigate this, and one step further, after hearing state all the concerned parties, Supreme Court convinced that local police is involved in this, and that is why CBI has to investigate.
Sir, timing.
And it is monitored by the Supreme Court.
No, the question is on timing.
So it means that BJP lead...
No, question is on timing.
Please tell me.
My question to you is on timing. My question to you was, you are aware you don't want 1 minute, sir. Let's establish what is happening. In July 2010, Kataria's name, BJP leader Kataria's name, first crops up in the Sohrabuddin case, after a statement is made by an aide of Sohrabuddin. Why is it only now, Mr. Shakti Singh Gohil, only now, close to 3 years later, on the eve of the Rajasthan elections, that the CBI is filing a charge sheet against this BJP leader and simultaneously letting off Bansal? Is the CBI trying to make the Congress happy and the BJP unhappy to balance out things?
Arnav, investigation agency has to arrest accused or name in the charge sheet whenever the appropriate time is there. Now, there was a matter before the Supreme Court that Tulsi Prajapati and Sohrabuddin, should it be clubbed or there should be a different FIR? Now, the Supreme Court has just before few weeks decided that matter and said no. Tulsi Prajapati fake encounter and Sohrabuddin, there is a one conspiracy, and that is why one charge sheet has to be filed. There should not be a separate complaint. So I think this is the only time when the supplementary charge sheet CBI can file. And
well, Rajasthan elections are in November, December this year, and you are filing a charge sheet 3 years later.
Gujarat,
I want to get in Nirmala Sitharaman. No, 1 second. Two things are happening simultaneously. Mr. Shakti Singh Gohil, everything will be looked at in context. Pawan Kumar Bansal is being let off. The CBI director is almost talking like a defense lawyer for Pawan Kumar Bansal today, on the one hand. And on the other, you file a charge sheet against the BJP leader Nirmala Sitharaman. Your response. I want the Nirmala Sitharaman to come in, please. Ms. Sitharaman, do you accept what the Congress leader has said, and what is your view on what the CBI has done?
Well, the Congress leader will only speak the language of his party, and the party is only hell-bent on using the CBI to oppress the opponents. You've rightly pointed out that the case is now peaked, and just before the Rajasthan elections, they want to pick up on some of the prominent leaders of the BJP there, just to make sure that they are, defamed. But the Sohrabuddin case, I'm sitting in Hyderabad, you've asked me to link up in this program from here. Let me take the example in Sohrabuddin's case. There is an angle, Hyderabad, Andhra Pradesh angle. Has the Home Minister of Andhra Pradesh ever been questioned? The Congress ruling party's Home Minister, has she been ever questioned on this matter? It was even observed in the court once that the Rajasthan and the Andhra Pradesh angle be checked up. They have not touched on Andhra Pradesh because it's Congress ruled. There are a few things which I want to bring into the discussion that you're bringing in today on this topic. encounter killings are happening, I do not know, more than 100 in Uttar Pradesh last 5 years. Last 10 years, if you look at the NHRC data and also the Crime Records Bureau's data, encounters are happening at least 3 or 4 times more than any other state in Uttar Pradesh. Has the CBI ever touched on any of the encounter killings in any state?
Ms. Sitaraman, the counter question to that will be, 1 minute, Mr. Gohil, your hand goes up, I see that. I'm going to get all voices. The simple counter question to you, Ms. Sitaraman, will be, that how come you keep changing your position on the CBI every few days? Last week, Nirmala Sitaraman, you personally were swearing by the CBI. Last week, when the CBI found something against Congress ministers, you supported them, you egged them on. The moment the CBI turned against your party men, Rajnath Singh, Vasundhara Raje Scindia and Arun Jaitley held a joint news conference. What kind of logic is that? Isn't that also extremely opportunistic, Ms. Sitaraman?
No, I'm actually grateful that you asked this question, because it will help us to remove the misconception about BJP's position as regards CBI. The CBI will have to be an independent and an objectively functioning professional body. There's no doubt about it. Let it take up cases which have any prima facie evidence. We have no objection.
Now, how do you establish what is evidence? If I were to ask Ranjit Kumar, because he takes a pro, I'll just get all voices in. Ranjit Kumar takes a pro Gujarat government position. Mr. Ranjit Kumar, be objective here and answer the question. Nirmala Sitaraman believes the CBI when it is investigating Railgate. Nirmala Sitaraman believes the evidence with the CBI when it is investigating Railgate, and despite no clear link being established by the CBI, Nirmala Sitaraman demands the resignation of the Railway Minister. Why then does Nirmala Sitaraman refuse to believe the CBI today when it claims to have evidence to link a top BJP leader in a fake encounter killing? Sorry, Nirmala, I want to take Ranjit Sinha to take that question. Yes, Mr. Sinha.
Ranjit Kumar, I'm sorry.
Please. Yes, sorry. You're not the CBI director. Sorry.
No, Ranjit Sinha.
Yes.
No.
I don't want to be. Yes. Go ahead, sir.
Well, I have a more fundamental question. And the fundamental question is that the state law and order is a state subject. Now, the IPS officers from the state, you don't believe in the state police. You pick up the very same IPS officers from the state, picked up, handpicked by the center, and put in the CBI. Now, when they come to the CBI, they become sacrosanct. And when they are in the state police, they are supposed to be very much under the control of the state government. Now, if I can say that if the state government controls the state police, the central government controls the CBI. Because it is the long arm of the central government which is using the handpicked officers of the CBI to get into these cases and file charge sheets. What is the credibility today of CBI after what has happened in Supreme Court?
How does the CBI have credibility when it is investigating Railgate?
It's the same thing. I don't agree whether Pawan Bansal or Kataria. I am not in favor or against anybody. All that I am saying is, after the Supreme Court admission by the CBI, why can't it be said that in every case which the CBI has filed charge sheet, there have been somebody or the other behind them trying to correct them? They must show their credibility first. It can't be opposition and ruling party. It has to be something much more than what they are doing today. Their credibility is lost. They have shown their face in the Supreme Court that they have been tampering, and they'd always tamper.
One second. Miss, what you are doing is very intelligent, but it is a flawed argument.
No, I'm
Mr.
not.
Mr. Ranjit Kumar, it is a
it's
flawed
not
argument.
A flawed argument, I'm sorry.
It is a
very.
It is a.
It's
I'll
a,
tell you why it's flawed.
It's a law and order subject.
No, sir, it's flawed.
Well, you tell me. Tell me, I'll answer.
Sir, it's flawed because
why
what you are trying
flawed?
To do. And what Nirmala Sitaraman is trying to do is that they are trying to use the image of the CBI as a caged parrot to their advantage to distract from the fact that the CBI in this case, may have evidence that links a BJP leader to a fake encounter.
I'm not for, I am not for or against. If there is evidence against Kataria, he will go to jail.
Sir, there is evidence.
If there is evidence against Bansal, he will go to jail.
Sir, there is evidence.
I am saying something different.
There is evidence.
I am saying a fundamental thing.
There is
fundamental
evidence.
Fundamental is that the very SP or the IPS, IPS officer of the state government,
one second.
He is with the state police, he is not supposed to be good.
One minute.
When he reaches the CBI, that very same IPS officer, he becomes suddenly very good.
Well, Nirmala,
why is that happening?
No, don't confuse. Don't confuse the argument.
Sacrosanct.
Don't confuse. Nirmala Sitharaman, tell me. Today the BJP. Today the BJP top leadership.
I'm not for the BJP or the Congress.
No, you are very much BJP leading.
No, I'm not for anybody.
No. Today the BJP top leadership.
No.
Today the BJP. Today the BJP top leadership. Today the BJP top leadership, Rajnath Singh says.
I'm a senior advocate and I'm replying on.
Rajnath Singh says.
Rajnath Singh may say whatever he wants to say.
Rajnath Singh says this is a well-planned political conspiracy by the UPA government to fix a. By the UPA government via the CBI to fix a senior BJP leader in a fake encounter case. Right? That's what he says. Now, what Nirmala Sitharaman, before I go to the CBI director, the former cabinet secretary, simple question to you. Why are you blind to the fact that there are 40 new witnesses the CBI has added in the supplementary charge sheet? Most of these witnesses have recorded their statements before a magistrate under section 164 of the Criminal Procedure Code. And the CBI, through the new evidence, is absolutely convinced that your leader, Gulabchand Kataria, had a direct role in hatching the conspiracy to eliminate Sohrabuddin.
You asked a very important question right at the beginning as to the timing of this supplementary charge sheet, and you didn't get any answer from the Congress. But let me say, was there no evidence against Satish Sharma? Was there no evidence against Sajjan Kumar? Quattrochi? Jagdish Titler? Why is that in the CBI's case, in all these instances, you had the CBI sitting over concrete evidence and also going and asking for appeal in the High Court, where the High Court had very clearly said after the Babri Masjid case, a conspiracy theory where they were trying to pin down BJP and RSS leaders, Ashok Singhal and so on. At that time, when the High Court says there's no conspiracy here, just take away this case and throws it out, they go back to say, no, we want an appeal. And all the cases that I've named, Sajjan Kumar, Titler, no, they wouldn't do anything. Whereas here, when there is no shred of evidence, and today you saw the leader of opposition, Raj Sabha, Shri Arun Jaitley, also come up with a very, very incriminating kind of evidence.
What evidence?
Show how the CBI, didn't he show that the CBI was hitting at
what
Amit
does it
Shah
prove?
Because they want to get at
what does it prove?
The
what does what does it prove? What Arun Jaitley says, what does it prove? Arun Jaitley, to the viewers first, what is Nirmala Sitharaman talking about? Arun Jaitley in the press conference, if I am not mistaken, he shows in the case of Amit Shah, and Amit Shah is a top BJP leader, I think now a general secretary, very close to Narendra Modi. Arun Jaitley pulls out a piece of paper. He says this is the investigator's report to the CBI director asking for permission to arrest Amit Shah. Am I correct? Nirmala Sitharaman, this is the paper which you're talking about, right?
Yes.
No, one second.
Yes.
And he says, in one part of this report, TSR Subramaniam, I want your reaction to this. In one part of this report, it is written, the agency writes, refer to Annexure C for its potential in respect to the Chief Minister also. In other words, Mr. TSR Subramaniam, Nirmala Sitharaman and Arun Jaitley have an argument that the BJP is being fixed. They are saying that when they are going after Amit Shah, the real target is not Amit Shah, the real target is Mr. Narendra Modi. And there was enough suggestion today at today's news conference, and not just in the Amit Shah case, but the Rathore case and the Kataria case, that actually what the CBI is trying to do is to fix Mr. Narendra Modi. I would request you, Nirmala Sitharaman, don't beat around the bush. If that's your suggestion, say so. Then we'll take the discussion forward and get a reaction from the other side as well.
No, I'm not beating around the bush.
You are.
I'm very clearly saying, yes, that's the evidence which Shri Arun Jaitley has shown. Let the Congress have the courage to refute it.
TSR Subramaniam, if an agency writes to the director that refer to this case for its potential in respect to the Chief Minister, potential in respect to the Chief Minister, does it mean the CBI is trying to fix Narendra Modi?
Arnab, I don't know exactly the facts and circumstances of this particular case, but one has been familiar over the years with how they function. The CBI is an extremely efficient organization, but it plays its politics also extremely well. I'm not
explain
going into
that.
The
explain
specifics
that.
Of Kataria or Bansal, about which I know nothing. But then they're also very effective, and they're also very creative. In all of these, so the fact is that we have to take all these into account. It is not for nothing that there are so many governors, there are so many NHRC members who have been from CBI. It is not for nothing that it is one cadre which is well represented. But in this case, I am not able to comment specifically what the facts are because I don't know them.
No, the facts are very clear. I want to get dear Karthikeyan in those. Nirmala Sitharaman, you know, we are on one point. Shakti Singh Goyal, I am coming to you. Nirmala Sitharaman makes a point, and nobody better than you to answer this, sir. Investigators' report to the CBI director says, refer again to Annexure C for its potential in respect of the Chief Minister also. Annexure C, Mr. Karthikeyan, contemplates whether Narendra Modi as Chief Minister, who also held the home portfolio, was aware of Amit Shah's attempt to influence the investigation into Sohrabuddin murder to disguise the facts. In other words, the BJP is producing this document to say this proves that the motive of the CBI is very sinister. The motive is to get Mr. Modi. Would you buy that?
See, from the what you read alone, I cannot make my comments because one cannot presuppose what is going to happen, what the intentions are and all that, you know. There are so many correspondence.
So BJP place. Is reading too much?
I can't say that because I'm not privy to all the facts of the case and I don't want to jump into any conclusion. But I would say this. Unfortunately, what happened today and your discussions, I've been traveling, so I've not followed what happened during the whole day, is reality may be something, but the perception is more important. Today, the perception all over the country and also endorsed by the Supreme Court is that, you know, action of this CBI in politically sensitive cases is a suspect.
Yes.
Very unfortunately. But that is the perception. Perception. See, why is it such charges are not being made against the FBI in America or many other investigative agencies? So that is the very reason the Supreme Court made these very, very strong comments. And also the group of ministers have been appointed. The very fact they're appointed shows that the government accepts there is a need to insulate CBI from external influence and all that. Many more steps start to be taken.
Point is
so true. That, unfortunately, is the premier investigative agency in the country, is the Central Bureau of Investigation. As Mr. Subramanian said, is quite competent. We have got competent officers. Most of them are hardworking, honest, objective and all that. But why in politically sensitive cases this type of charges took place? Because, not fair to the country to have an
organization. Sir, I agree with you. Yeah. The bottom line is this, Mr. Karthikeyan, that are we all reading something very wrong? You see, two things are happening on one day. A CBI director is telling Times Now that just because there is so much talk about Pawan Kumar Bansal in the telephone transcript, just because his name is referred to, just because people close to him are talking about him, does not mean that we have to interrogate him immediately. No, and on the other side, you're going after a BJP.
I'm surprised.
Are you surprised with
that? I'm surprised because, you know, during the investigation, you don't give a running commentary on what is going to happen.
Yes.
Investigation is not completed. When the investigation is completed, the result will, of course, will go to the court.
Precisely.
I personally thought, you know, every day you can't make a comment. Maybe something else will come tomorrow.
Is it totally...
See, these are avoidable controversies today.
Is it totally ridiculous? And you've held that high chair as well.
No,
is it totally ridiculous?
I don't know what the director said, but...
Can I quote you what the director said?
If he had said that,
sir, can I
would say that it was avoidable today. You don't make comments during the investigation.
Why is he making these comments?
Because unless you are...
No, why is this CBI director
I
making these
you
comments?
You should ask him. I don't know. In fact,
would
I
you
don't
have
know.
Made
I
these
mean,
comments?
I have not even heard
director?
That because the whole day I was traveling.
No,
I have not heard that. But, you know, this is not...
Because
it results in unnecessary controversies and debates going on.
Precisely. What is the message the CBI...
Blame game.
What the CBI director says, Mr. CSR Subramaniam, and this is the...
Maybe he was under pressure to do something. There is no need for him.
No, is it possible that the...
Investigation is on till it's concluded. Anything can happen.
The CBI director, none other than the CBI director, Mr. Subramaniam, is saying, and I'm quoting the CBI director, the Ranjit Sinha says, it is difficult to prove a case against Pawan Kumar Bansal. But the probe is still on and something new may come up. Second point, he says, Singla bragging in phone conversation about Bansal's influence does not prove that Bansal was on board. And then he says there is no evidence of Bansal taking money. And that close proximity does not prove anything in Railgate. Mr. T.S.R. Subramaniam, the only thing I realize out of this is that while the investigation is going on, Mr. CBI director has also already given some kind of a clean chit. It may not technically be a clean chit. Why would he do something like that?
I agree, Arnab, and I agree that it is a little unfortunate that he needs to make these kinds of comments when the investigation is on, number one. Number two, there is so much of circumstantial evidence, if not direct evidence, linking the minister. And somebody raised the question, he did not have to resign. He had to resign because
precisely.
He was so close to home. Now, it is unfortunate, it gives the impression that the CBI has already made up his mind that he is not guilty, and unless something dramatic new develops linking him directly. Now, I would expect him to be treated as a suspect, to be interrogated at some stage in the last 10 days or so, fairly gently, but not treated as an accused. But this is a little surprising, and while investigation is going on, it is much better when officers keep their mouth shut.
But they are not keeping their mouth shut. Is it not possible? Is it not possible, Mr. Ranjit Sinha, that the CBI director's comments will prejudice the investigation?
Well, again, I am Ranjit Kumar. I don't want to be in the position of Ranjit Sinha.
I am extremely sorry. I have made you CBI director for the second time.
No, I don't want to be in his position. He must be in a very... I don't know what kind of a position he is in. But anyway, to answer the question, investigation is such a sacrosanct thing that one must not in any way try to come out with what the facts are at any stage prior to the charge sheet.
But why is he doing
because
that?
It may try to influence that.
No, but why is the CBI director
you
doing
must
that?
Not try to. It's wrong on his part. He should not have. That is why I say and I maintain that the CBI today is the long arm of the central government. Because the central government otherwise has no law and order within its jurisdiction. The Constitution of India says that the law and order is a state subject. It's not a central subject. So CBI has become itself the long arm of the central government.
Senior,
the state government had its own police.
Okay, let's take the
central government has no police.
Pro-Congress point of view. KC Mittal. KC Mittal is former president of the Delhi High Court Bar Association. He takes a pro-Congress, pro-government point of view on this. Mr. Mittal, the CBI director says two things have happened today. The CBI director seems to be almost wanting to give Pawan Kumar Bansal a clean chit. He's not saying technically clean chit, but he says there's very little to go by. That's one, point number one. Point number two, simultaneously the CBI goes after the BJP in a fake encounter case related to Gujarat. In your view, Mr. Mittal, is the CBI director nervous? Is he worried? Maybe I upset the government too much? Maybe it's time to do a balancing act?
No, you see, the basic thing which according to me we need to understand is that the investigation, how it is to be conducted, is prescribed by law. And the Criminal Procedure Court, it maintains a confidentiality which one has to maintain. As a matter of fact, so far as the Sarabuddin encounter case is concerned, the position is very clear because the matter was not referred to CBI by any government agency, but it was referred by the Supreme Court. The investigation was initially conducted and charge sheet was filed. Now this is a supplementary charge sheet which has been filed. The role of the CBI is over at that. Subsequently, what has happened is that the ACMM Mumbai has taken cognizance and issued summons to Gulab Chand Kataria. Therefore, CBI doesn't come into the picture at that stage because...
Why did the CBI wake up... Oh, Nirmala Sitharaman. No, Nirmala Sitharaman. Why did the CBI... The charge sheet against Kataria, the BJP leader, comes up after 6 years. It comes up 4 months before a state election in Rajasthan. It comes up within days of the Bansal affair. Why did the CBI suddenly wake up to this?
No, that's not really the point.
That's exactly the point.
But that's the point.
Context very clearly.
That's the point. This is happening in a context.
You see,
why do you say it's not the point?
That's not the point.
And therefore,
I'll tell you one thing more. You see, kindly consider one aspect of the matter. Once the magistrate has taken a cognizance, he has prima facie found at the stage of taking cognizance that material evidence is there on record. Now, if somebody is not satisfied with the order of the magistrate, it is open to them to go in the High Court, file a petition and 482.
No, that's you're taking a super technical, You're taking a hyper legal point of view. Nirmala Sitharaman. You're taking a hyper legal point of view, sir. One second. Ranjit Sinha is countering you. Ranjit Sinha. Ranjit Sinha responding to Mr. Mittal. Ranjit Kumar responding to Mr. Mittal.
Mr. Mittal is going one step ahead. The charge sheet has been filed by the CBI in the Mumbai court. It is on that CBI that the magistrate takes cognizance. The magistrate takes cognizance only when something comes before it. And I have not heard of any magistrate till date where CBI has filed a charge sheet and the magistrate has not taken cognizance of it. So that is one step further. Today what you are discussing is why did the CBI file the charge sheet after 6 years? That is the question. That Mr. Mittal is not answering.
No.
Yes, I am answering. I will answer that question also. 1 minute, Mr. Ranjit Kumar, 1 minute. You know the procedure. If you just permit me for a minute, you know the procedure, how the case diary is maintained by the police. The law requires maintenance of case diary, which contains the entire investigation record. Are you wanting to say that all that record is false? Are you wanting to say all that record
is
dishonest?
No, record which is coming today. I am saying why is the record coming today when the trial has started? The trial has started in Bombay. Your supplementary charge sheet is coming now.
Just 1 second. It is not a record prepared in a day. The record can't be prepared in a day or it can't be prepared in a month.
Well, we don't know that. Can you vouch that it is not prepared in a day? Because the charge sheet has already been filed earlier. The case is already started.
Ranjit, 1 second. The moment you know supplementary charge sheet can be filed, if the evidence comes on record...
Of course it can be filed, but why has it come after 6 years?
Mr. Mittal, there are two points. There are two points which come up. First is the basic question today is this. There are two cases. One is of a Rajasthan BJP minister Kataria and second is of the sacked minister Bansal. Now, while the two cases can be considered to be a fair comparison by some, what we are asking is why is the CBI giving a clean chit to Pawan Kumar Bansal without even interrogating him? While moving to file a charge sheet against Kataria, this is bound to raise the suspicion about the intent of the CBI given the timing. That's question number one. Question one. And question two, Mr. Mittal, is answer this one. As per the Prevention of Corruption Act, point 13, B and C, a close reading of these two will tell you that even if a person is not directly taking a bribe, if there are people under his control or if there are people who report to him directly or indirectly who are involved in such acts of corruption, then you cannot give the individual a clean chit. I don't know if the CBI director doesn't know the law, Mr. Mittal, or he expects the rest of India not to know the law. Why is he giving Pawan Kumar Bansal a clean chit?
That of course you can better ask the director CBI, not me. But let me tell you two things. The first point which you are raising, you see, each and every case depends on each fact. You can't equate one with another.
Sir, that's...
If we start doing that, just one second, permit me for a minute. The function of the investigating agency is to collect evidence. When they collect evidence, whatever evidence comes on record, on the basis of that evidence, they have to proceed. On the basis of lead, they have to proceed. On the basis of available evidence and whatever required, the leads available, they have to investigate, which they are doing. On that basis, the investigating officer takes a decision. Therefore, there is nothing wrong either way. You see, the, you
no,
can't
no,
mix
no.
the two cases and,
Nirmala Sitaraman.
And draw an analogy.
No, no, Nirmala Sitaraman. No. Yes, Ms. Sitaraman.
The Mr. Mittal, who's elaborating laboriously on this, supplementary charge sheet and that it can be brought in, I want to ask of him, why no supplementary charge sheets are coming on Satish Sharma, Sajjan Kumar, or even on Jagdish Titler? So why are these kind of a supplementary charge sheets dumped forever? But where there is a very clear case... No, wait a minute. You can't labor on an argument and then tell a supplementary charge sheet when the evidence
Arnav,
is based on the diary is
discussion
coming in.
Is something...
Tell us why. Mr. Mittal, if you're raising a legal point which is also to be answered on those cases in which Congress's leaders are not ever appearing. So, please don't labor on this point so much. It's a clear-cut case of political vendetta. And this today, a whole argument of, trying to form a GOM on CBI.
This is not fair. You are not giving an opportunity.
It is a eyewash.
Well,
it's a total eyewash because during the Lokpal debate,
I'd like to ask you, Nirmala Sitaraman, Nirmala Sitaraman, Nirmala Sitaraman, no, 1 minute, Nirmala Sitaraman, let me ask you something, Nirmala Sitaraman.
You're putting words into my mouth and you're not even allowing me to finish.
Nirmala Sitaraman, the only question I have for you and I then go to Shakti Singh Goyal is, I understand that you're all worked up about Kataria.
No, have only one question, but you are all words into my mouth.
Nobody's putting words in your
mouth. If you want to have the debate done like this, go ahead.
No, Ms. Sitaraman, I have a question for you.
You're not allowing me to complete my point.
I have a question for you.
You may have any number of questions, and I'm willing to answer, but you won't permit me to answer, is my grief.
I will ask you one question, then you can answer, then I'll go to Shakti Singh Goyal. My question to you is very simple. Please tell me, I understand your anger at the CBI today. Where was this anger, Nirmala Sitaraman, of the BJP? When in the Harin Pandya case, the CBI went along with the Modi government's contention that Pandya was murdered to avenge the 2002 riots. Why did you go with the CBI contention then? Why did nobody from the Gujarat government or the BJP question what the CBI said in the Harin Pandya case? Please tell me directly. And why did you not take such a cynical position in the Harin Pandya case? Because it suited you politically? Ms. Sitaraman?
The CBI has...
Yes. No. Yes, please
you're
go ahead.
You're giving me the time to answer
no,
this
please go ahead.
Question
please go ahead.
Or the several that you've presumed my answers for?
No, I'm asking you a question.
You've asked me several questions and much before I gave my reply, you've also presumed my replies.
No.
So, please permit me to answer. The CBI has never been misused by the BJP. And this, I'm not stating because I'm in the BJP. You may ask many of the professionals who have been in the CBI. The CBI's misuse is speaking with the Congress. And I will insist on saying this. That this eyewash of a GOM that has been formed today is not going to get anywhere in making the CBI independent. The Lokpal debate time, very clearly, we gave a formula about 13 to 14 points. Both the leaders of opposition had very clearly stated as to how the BJP would want this to be
Shakti
forwarded so that the CBI can become independent.
Shakti
Singh
Goyal.
Therefore, I think it is important that the Congress party and the government explain as to why.
Shakti
Hello?
Singh, yes, I understand your point. Shakti Singh Goyal wanted to respond.
It is for the Congress and the government to tell us why during the Lokpal debate, having gone that far, they have not progressed further to make the CBI independent.
Shakti Singh
no
Goyal.
No point in telling us
you
now.
You didn't ask that question when the CBI went along with your position on Harin Pandya. You avoided my question on Harin Pandya. You didn't answer a word on Harin Pandya, Nirmala
Sitaraman. I will still say No, you're not permitting me, Arnav. You may presume that we went with the CBI. We've gone through with the independence of the CBI.
Yes.
We have not interfered in
Shakti
A
Singh
case,
Goyal.
Nor have we interfered in B case.
Shakti Singh Goyal wanted to respond. Your turn, Mr. Goyal.
Arnav, I have heard Ms. Sitaraman for 18 minutes with great patience. Now, at least 3 minutes without interruption may be given to me. Now, the fact of the case is that in Gujarat, more than 36 small time criminals were killed by a police in fake encounter, and each and every after encounter, there was a press conference by the senior IPS officer, and in the press conference IPS officers have told at relevant time ki hame inputs tha IB ka, Narendra Modi ko marne ke liye koi aa raha hai, humne watch rakhi thi, mudbhed mein mara gaya, uski jeb se ek cheat nikla hai jisme likha tha main Modi ko marne aa raha tha, and he had the terrorist connection, aur uske paas se ek country made pistol deshi tamancha mila hai, and because of this fake encounters the sympathy wave pro Modi was the beneficiary. Before the Supreme Court, when matter came up, Gujarat government has investigated, arrested IPS officers, filed an affidavit saying that all were fake encounters for name and fame. Ye police officer kar rahe the, we will take actions. Supreme Court didn't believe Why in the Amit Shah case does the CBI write in to the director that we must examine this for its potential vis-a-vis the chief minister? Just answer that one question.
So what is wrong?
What is wrong?
What is wrong?
Does this not amount to an attempt to fix Narendra Modi?
Look, whoever is, I am not saying put Narendra Modi behind bars. I just say that free and fair investigation is necessary.
No.
This investigation is going on under the observation of the Supreme Court.
Mr. Gohil, while filing a case against Singla, does the same CBI say we should look at Singla's case for its potential to fix or for its potential vis-a-vis Bansal? Or in looking at Bansal's case, will the CBI say we should look at this case for its potential vis-a-vis the Prime Minister? Then why in the case of Amit Shah does the same CBI say that we should look at this case for its potential vis-a-vis the Chief Minister? Just answer that one question, please.
Yes, Arnav, CBI took enough time to investigate, and if you look at sheet, CBI has done a great job. Because report was filed before the Supreme Court.
Counter.
And in Amit Shah's case also, no 482 was filed.
Nirmala Sitharaman wants to counter 1.5 minutes on the debate. I need to go to DR Karthik and Nirmala Sitharaman. Quick rebut. Yes, please.
So Arnav, nation wants to know. Give a clean check
nation wants to know who is pursuing BJP leadership
to come out and
to defend one accused.
And also, let me ask Mr. Gohil, in Maharashtra, more than 300 encounters have happened over some number of years in the name of cleansing all the underworld dons. On that, Mr. Gohil, what would you want to say? Have there been any kind of a CBI investigation?
Yes,
on that?
I will reply, Arnav. Give me time, I will reply to her. Them?
You will reply each time, but you will not
reply to her,
telling
Arnav.
Me that the CBI. You will reply. Tell me about the way in which CBI is defending Mr. Bansal. How do you justify? And are you trying to suggest that if there is actually a threat on the life of the chief minister, that they, because
okay, reply,
Gohil,
Mr. Gohil.
Is going to protest,
yes, now it's
will do
Congress turn to
the
reply.
Protection aspect.
Arnav, I will reply to Sitaraman's question. Give me an opportunity.
You have one, quickly, sir.
Here the Sitaraman is saying that in other state there were fake encounters. Why about only Gujarat? We never demanded. Congress has not given this investigation to CBI. Your Modi government, when thought that there is some problem, before the Supreme Court, this Modi government filed an affidavit Initially, investigation was carried out by this state government. They have said these are the fake encounters for name and fame. Our police officers were doing wrong. The Supreme Court didn't believe this, that only for name and fame.
No,
fake encounters are there, and that is why Supreme
Court. So why was the CBI waiting?
Investigation
to
CBI.
No.
Doesn't work,
this
sir.
This is the order of the Supreme Court. What? No. I have the copy of the order of the Supreme Court.
Why did you wake up after 6 years?
The Supreme Court has said that larger conspiracy has to be investigated.
So why did you wake up after 6 years? The charge sheet comes after 6 years. Why did you wake up after 6 years?
Please let me ask one question of Mr. Gohil.
I am running short of time, Nirmala Sitharaman. Very briefly, I want to close with Mr. Kartikeyan.
Just one question of Mr. Gohil for him to answer, because he's so keen on answering.
1 minute, quickly,
questions. Please,
without wasting any more time. Yes, please.
The Supreme Court has said about Ashwini Kumar. The Supreme Court has said about CBI, trying to do favors to the government. Why Shakti Singh Gohil doesn't want to obey those orders of the Supreme Court?
Point taken. It's a rhetorical question.
And are you suggesting
it's a rhetorical question?
Arnav, I will reply.
It's a rhetorical question.
Be
we can
risk,
let that pass.
Be at risk.
It's a rhetorical question.
I will reply to her, Arnav.
Protecting the Chief Minister is a shame, Arnav, that you do not want
it's
to care
a rhetorical.
About the
she has a question. I have an answer.
Well, let's find an answer in 10 seconds.
I have an answer. Give me an opportunity.
10 seconds to answer.
I have an answer, Arnav. She has a question.
And I'm waiting, and the time is 10 seconds to answer, sir, quickly.
Ms. Sitharaman, your own government was there, NDA government, when Supreme Court has said that's autonomy to CBI.
One second. This is not going to be settled
silent.
Here. To my question to Mr. Kartikeyan. One second, gentlemen. My question to Mr. Kartikeyan.
Mr. Kartikeyan,
on a broader perspective tonight. No, one
so
second.
So 1999 to 2004, people were in power. Who was stopping them?
Okay.
Arun Pandya was killed.
Okay, can I just request tempers to cool for 2 minutes? Tempers to Mr. Kartikeyan, on a broad perspective, 1 minute, Nirmala Sitharaman, please allow the floor to Mr. Kartikeyan. My question is to Mr. Kartikeyan. Mr. Kartikeyan, on a broader perspective, today, do you think it is fair for the people of this country to actually come forward and ask, where is the consistency in what the CBI is doing? CBI wakes up sometime. CBI goes to sleep sometime on a case. Sometimes CBI picks up a case. Sometimes CBI says, we'll go after Bansal. Sometimes CBI says, we've decided not to. It's all too arbitrary. We talk about independence for the CBI. But what about the, you give independence to a organization that has a sense of accountability to the people.
No, independence with direct accountability.
To whom? What if tomorrow a completely independent CBI director goes after whom he wants, does what he wants?
Nobody says that. Nobody wants it. You can't give. Even the Supreme Court, no single judge. There are always 2 judges, 3 judges, 5 judges. Even at the highest level, one judge doesn't, so one can't give it to all authority to one man, director CBI. You know, that is a whole reform is right from the way, the method of appointment and accountability, who will be supervisory, that's a different subject you need.
I agree with you.
Okay. But only thing is, this country deserves a better, credible, premier investigative agency. If it can happen in America, nobody questions that. Okay, many other countries, why can't it happen here? It will happen
point.
Here. Supreme Court has made the observation. The very fact the government have appointed a group of ministers of eminent, senior lawyers and all that, that shows the government agrees. Yes, there is something to be done.
Yeah.
I am sure it's a separate debate, what
absolutely.
All
TSR
that.
Subramaniam.
Certainly.
TSR Subramaniam, is all this confusion happening principally because the CBI is under the thumb of the government, that the CBI director always has to look over his shoulder and see who is making happy, who is displeasing?
Arnab, by and large, it is absolutely true, except in rare exceptions, this is absolutely correct. And the danger is, as you pointed out now, we should not go from the frying pan to the fire.
Yeah.
It is abundantly clear government's umbilical cord should be cut. But on the other hand, we need proper checks and balances. Otherwise, it would be a loose cannon. It's too powerful an agency to be left on its own. It has to have proper control mechanism to ensure that proper independent mechanism. And that's another subject. We hope that the GOM is not an eyewash. We do hope it must go outside government control.
Yes, but
if a good Lokpal were there, that would be a good solution. Otherwise, an excellent committee of management is required. CBI cannot be given full independence.
Absolutely. The CBI director must answer the nation on whether his comments of late have exceeded his own brief. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen.